Today we will extract some DNA from the seabob shrimp. Here we have some seabob shrimp on ethanol. So it's 96% ethanol, so that's good for preserving the DNA of the shrimp. We work with clean material, so it's all sterilized. We take one piece of the shrimp, but I will show you the whole shrimp. So it's already cut because there has been a sample taken before. Okay. This. For today we will take only a small piece of this leg. It's a small swimming leg, a pleopod of the seabob shrimp, and from this part you will extract the DNA. So we put it in an empty tube, and the rest of the shrimp we keep in our ethanol for if this extraction fails. We still have enough material to do a second one or a third one even. Here we add 500 microliters of SeaTac. Each tube. So now we froze the tissue with the CTAP, so the cells will be broken down. And now we will add some beads, just a small spoon of beads. And also in the second one. Some beads and also some proteinase K, and these two together they will further break down cells and release the DNA from the nucleus. So we will add only 6 microliters of proteinase K. It's an enzyme, so we keep it on ice. Otherwise it will be break down fast. Okay, and now we will beat it with a bead beater. So it's a mechanical destruction of the cell to make sure all the DNA material from the nucleus is released. Careful, it's only 30 seconds on max frequency. We are at the end of our extractions. We precipitated the proteins, so the DNA was in solution. Then we precipitated the DNA and we removed the solution. So here we have the pellet, it's only pure DNA. So we didn't film the previous steps because it was just pipetting, and it's a long work. It took us half the afternoon. And now it's the pellet is only DNA, and we will dissolve it in 100 microliters of pure water. So now the DNA pellet can dissolve in the water, and this tube we have the clean and pure DNA of the CBOB shape of our sample, and this we can use in the future for PCR amplification, for taxonomy, for population structure.